Hello, I'm Ariana Falk, and I'm a cellist and music director of the Massachusetts chapter of the Fulbright Association. And my wonderful colleague Deborah Nemko and me are both alumni of the Fulbright program, having done scholarships in Europe in recent years. The mission of the Fulbright program to promote international exchange of ideas is a wonderful fit for the world of music. And the Fulbright has been a wonderful promoter of music and musicians over its entire 75-year history. The music world is such a natural fit in its international exchange of composers, performers, teachers, and students. So I can think of no more fitting way to celebrate that international exchange that Fulbright is given us by giving some music back to the world of Fulbright. We'll start today with three fantasy pieces by Robert Schumann.
Thank you.
So I'm going to play now the first movement of the solo cello suite by Gaspar Cassado, Spanish composer. And Cassado was a cellist. In fact, he was a child prodigy who went to study with the great Pablo Casals, who was one of the great cellists as well as humanitarians of the 20th century in Madrid. This solo cello piece is one of the few great solo pieces for the instrument that had been written at that point. Of course, the solo Bach cello suites kind of inspire everything for solo cello ever written since then, and this is no exception. So the piece is a set of three stylized dances. I'll be playing just the first one today, the Preludio-fantasia, and it is sort of a stylized saraband with a really fantastical feel to it. Please enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm pleased to be performing the following couple of works by Fina Shapiro, who was actually a very famous concert pianist, Dutch concert pianist. She started off born in Indonesia, and her family moved to Europe so that she could get the best piano education possible. She studied in Paris. They spent the summers in the Netherlands, but in 1939, it was apparent they could not leave because the Nazis were getting ready to invade the Netherlands. And since she was half Jewish, it became dangerous for her. She was told she had to join the Kulturkammer, which is an organization that was dedicated to promoting Nazi sanctioned music, and she decided not to. She was against it, and so she was no longer allowed to perform, even though she was a great performer. And she had a love for composition. She did quite a bit of composing, but unfortunately, most of her works at the time were lost when a bomb exploded in her house and she was forced to move with her family. Fortunately, she did survive the war. She left for the United States afterwards with her family and ended up teaching at Bennington College. In fact, a couple of works were written at that time. So unfortunately, her works are not available, but I hope to have them published in the near future.
Thank you.